Hey guys, this is Ray, and this film documenting the daily lives of people in different jobs that I met during my year of studying in the UK. This is the first artist I interviewed, and her name is Sarah. She is a clay artist who lives in Brighton. But I am very sorry to tell you that since both of us were so excited when we met, therefore I forgot to record the opening remarks. So let's follow Sarah's explanation directly to understand her daily work.
That was the first one I ever did. That's a more recent one. So this is all for the textiles, and there's different kinds of fabric and things for embroidery, which I haven't done in years because it takes so long.
Yeah.
And then I discovered polymer clay and I went a bit crazy. So this is all for polymer clay stuff. There's so many things in my house.
Yeah.
Different kinds of tools and, for example, things for putting in. You can put the clay in there and then bake it, and you can make jewellery from that. I'll show you some of it.
Yeah, like the modelling for baking.
Exactly, and then you can use it afterwards as like a pendant.
Oh,
or,
yeah.
These ones are too heavy for earrings, but the smaller ones you can use.
Yeah,
for,
sure.
Earrings. And then things like this. Stud backs, they're called findings.
Oh.
Findings, so you have hooks and stud backs, things like that.
Yeah.
And then cutters.
Cutters.
So cutters is a problem for all polymer clay artists. We have too many.
Yeah.
So
oh
my
god.
This is one of my boxes, but I have three small boxes and then the big ones.
Oh my god. Mm. So the big one used to making necklace or...
Yeah, or sometimes big earrings because I like
big earrings.
So I like to make a variety of sizes and things like that. And then there's hair clips in here. There's fabric for making, like a thread for making necklaces.
Mm-hmm.
And then little charms.
Yeah. Oh. Oh my god. Well, I usually see it in the making nails store.
Yeah. So much. I mean, a lot of the things you can use for nails, you can use for this. So, for example, you know the glitter powders.
Yeah.
You can use them on clay, mm-hmm. and you can use a similar effect.
Yeah.
But you have to seal them with something. So I also have resin, UV resin. So
UV.
I can put a coat of resin on some things if I want to.
Yeah.
Not everything needs it. And then there's other kinds of things like textures.
Oh.
I love textures.
Yeah.
So you can roll these into the clay. And today I'm going to show you something using textures.
Oh.
And it's a technique taken from Japanese metalwork.
Oh.
And it's called Mokumegane.
Yeah.
And I'll show you. But we kind of stole it.
Yeah.
So yeah, I love texture. I love making things with interesting textures. Well, I love everything, as you can see.
So the texture is the one of the style that's your favorite.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I think for me the most important thing in my art is I love pattern.
Yeah.
So I love things that I'm not very good with plain color. I like lots of detail,
it's
lots
okay.
of pattern. And then there's things like, so these are the sorts of things you can put these as a powders.
Oh, the powders. I thought it's the color.
So these are powders and you can mix them in the clay or you can put them on top of the clay to
and
make
the UV.
Clay shiny. And then you can put UV resin on top if you want. You can mix it into the resin.
Yeah.
There's just so many things. Foils are really good. So like gold leaf.
Gold leaf.
It's not real gold. It's a fake. It would be too expensive.
It's the real gold.
No.
It's not. Okay.
And this is some sand I'm going to use because I want to. I bought a necklace and it's made of glass. This is something I bought. I went to an art market fair thing. I have too much jewellery. Right. So I bought this and this is glass mosaic.
Oh.
Isn't it beautiful? But I want to recreate this in clay.
Recreate.
So I want to use clay designs to make this all in clay, in different colours. And between the mosaic pieces is something called grout, which holds it all together and covers it. So I'm going to use sand mixed with liquid clay to cover. We'll see. It's a It's a project I'm going to do over Christmas when I have no markets and no pressure and I can just have a bit of fun.
Yeah. Have you ever joined the market, the artist market?
Yeah, I go to markets every month.
Every month?
I've got one on Saturday. Oh. But you're welcome to come and see.
Yeah.
And then these are some of my pieces for me that I keep for me because I...
Oh.
Sometimes I just... This one, I see the big earrings.
Oh, I like the big one. Oh my god, I love this. I saw it on Instagram and I really love it.
Oh, thank
yeah,
you.
Yeah, the snake. Yeah.
It's really annoying to sand the edges.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I like that design.
Yeah, it must take a lot of time because of the pattern.
Yeah. So the pattern. Let me explain the pattern.
Just thought about
and
something.
I will show you some play soon.
Okay? Oh, it's okay.
Okay. So I love leopard print.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And but I like it in really fun colours. This is like my most boring leopard print outfit, but it was a clean shirt. So this is called a cane. And you make it by making a really, really big piece, like with many of these. So you make these. You make rolls of clay.
Yeah.
And you put them around each other to make a picture. And the picture goes all the way through the clay. And you start really, really big, like short and fat.
Oh.
And then you make it smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller.
Yeah,
and you reduce it down.
Like the handmade candy.
Like exactly rock,
yeah.
You know rock.
Rock.
In,
also,
Brighton rock.
Yeah,
it's the same idea.
Oh.
So you start really big and then you make it smaller and you kind of stretch as you go and the picture stays all the way through. So when you slice through this will be the same picture all the way through.
Yeah, some baking like biscuits also use these things.
And then I did a mushroom.
Oh, mushroom.
So it started off really big and then this is kind of. Oh, no.
Oh my god.
This is the medium size.
Oh my god, it's so cute. Oh my god.
And then I made it smaller.
Wow.
And then even smaller.
Even so smaller, cute. Yeah. Like the rock.
Yeah, exactly. And then yeah. I can make stud earrings, big earrings, necklaces, and yeah. I've got different things. So and then this is dragonfly wings.
Oh, dragonfly wings.
So this is a cane I made for dragonfly, making dragonflies.
It's hard to imagine because
I will show you. So that goes, hang on, which way around? Did I do it like that? I think so.
Oh my god.
No, that way. There you go.
Oh, the dragonfly wings.
And I will show you the finished dragonfly. And then leaves. This was just a leaf cane I did. I haven't really used it. And I have experiments that go wrong. Some things, this one didn't work. So it looks pretty before it's baked.
Mm-hmm.
And then when it's baked, because there was quite a lot of translucent clay,
yeah, yeah.
Which goes darker when you bake it because you can only see that when the light's through,
yeah.
It looks really dark and horrible when it's baked.
Yeah, yeah,
so
sure.
I will, the thing with this clay you can use forever.
Yeah.
Once it's baked, you can't do anything with it. But before it's baked, you can use it for something new. So I can use this
mm-hmm.
for something else. This one is like stained glass.
Oh my god, this one is so... It looks so... How do you say technical?
Do you know what? It's one of the easiest canes to make.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yeah. There are a lot... Once you get started, you kind of learn a lot of techniques. Let me see. Have I got any of the big one? I finished it all. Okay.
I've
got sections of it. So this one's a rose.
Oh, wow, it's a rose. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And there's a blue version of that pink one.
Ooh.
And what else have I got? Rainbow. I never used this one.
Oh, the rainbow. Ooh, that's so cute.
Yeah, these are. There's just. And there's so many things you can do. It's so much fun.
Yeah.
Okay, that's probably all I'll show you for now. Yes, so yeah, lots of different things, and then lots of different, so you can buy blank pen, blank pen things, and I can cover pens.
Oh my god, so many tools.
Bookmarks, I haven't even made any. Oh. I just buy supplies, and then I think I'll use them one day.
Yeah.
So yeah, lots and lots and lots of things we can do.
Yeah, before we're making something, we always spend a lot of time to thinking what kind of things I have to do. Well, this is
art. Fun.
This is artist.
This is all the supplies for things as well. So this has got like, that one's just masked when I'm sanding. And then things I can cover in clay.
Mm.
So you can actually put wood in the oven.
Oh.
And cardboard.
Cardboard.
When you're cooking clay, and it won't burn because the temperature for cooking clay is low enough.
Oh, yeah.
And glass, of course. Mm. So you can do different things. So shall I show you some of my work?
Okay.
So these are the big,
the most exciting part.
So this one is the Northern Lights. Do you know the Aurora Borealis in the sky?
Yeah.
This is a replica I did for this.
So
for
the Northern Lights. The dream scene for everyone.
Yeah, I would love to go to Iceland and see it. So that's the Northern Lights. And actually, if you really charge it under a light for a while, it glows in the dark in the center.
Yeah.
Which is really fun.
It's really beautiful.
This one uses that rose cane that I showed you.
Oh, the rose pattern. Oh my god, it's really beautiful.
Thank you. Let's see some more bits. So this one is a technique called Bargello.
Bargello.
Where you cut and you move the slice like this.
Oh.
And then I put resin over.
Like the beads.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly, but you don't have to weave it.
Yeah.
So in a way, it's easier.
Yeah.
This one is the same technique as your necklace.
Yeah.
But using green colors.
Oh, right. Yeah, this is the same pattern for my necklace. Oh. Yeah, I really like it.
This is like one of the easiest techniques. You could do this.
Oh, thank you.
Definitely. Definitely. Like a rose.
Oh.
Another cane.
Oh,
this is so much fun. Yeah, there's just a lot of fun techniques. And then, let's see. So there's things you can do. So you can cover things with clay. And you can make things out of clay. So this is all clay with
this
a coat of
clay.
Resin.
Yeah, because you told me this can just bake in the oven.
Yes.
So I was...
And really... I put resin on because it's a soap dish.
Yeah.
So I just wanted it to be extra. But you can actually... it is waterproof clay.
Yeah.
Once it's baked, it's waterproof.
So this one is 20 pounds.
Yeah.
Oh my god, this one is... Oh my god.
I love this texture.
Oh, I love this. Yeah. Oh,
that's
oh my
using
god.
Scrap clay.
Oh.
So you collect the scraps together, you squash them, and then you slice them and lie them like this, like this, like this, like this, next to each other, and it creates this pattern.
Oh my god, this one is so pretty. Yeah.
Thank you. There's some buttons from scrap clay.
Oh, my mom will love it.
And then some pens. So that's using the leopard print.
Oh, how to make it?
So I show you in the box, right?
Oh, yeah.
So they come in pieces. So you cover that piece and you cover that
just
piece and you bake it.
Oh.
And then I put a coat of resin. Because it's a pen, I want it to be extra strong.
Yeah.
Because it's going to get a lot of use.
Mm-hmm.
And then you just, there's a machine you use that pushes all the pieces together.
Yeah.
And then you've got your pen. That's the stained glass cane. That's the blue one I showed you.
Oh my god, it's so... I was about to say Chinese. Oh my god, it's so pretty.
Thank you. And then this one is like, you know, like agate stone?
Oh, yeah. Oh, the cut shade of it, of the stone.
Yeah, exactly. It's it's clay, but it's designed to look like that.
Yeah, so that was your inspiration.
And this one has no varnish, no resin. This is sanded smooth, so you can sand clay. This one has no resin or anything. This is the natural clay.
Oh, this is natural clay. Yeah, oh my god.
And can I touch it? Yeah, of course you can, please.
Wow, it's so... How do you say? I never touched it before.
This one is...
Yeah, the feeling is totally different.
This one's sanded, so this feels smooth.
Oh, it's smooth. It's smooth. Yeah. It can feel the sand.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And this one is textured.
Oh,
this one is
so beautiful. Wow.
But if you have the light on, she
will... Oh, you're preparing a light. Oh, this can... For the candle.
Yeah, all of those are for candles.
Yeah.
Well, you can use anything. You can put sweets in it or whatever.
Sure.
And so that's a textured one. And then it has a little bit of shimmer on the... Can you see on the top of the leaf? I use some of that powder for the shimmer.
Yeah.
And then I just use varnish because the powder can come off.
Yeah.
So there's a little bit, just one layer of varnish over it as well.
Okay.
Yeah, so...
So pretty.
And then a bookmark that I made that... Nobody ever bought, but it's supposed to be like coral under the
sea. This is fabric, a silk, something.
This is clay.
Oh, this is clay.
Yeah. Oh my god. You can touch it.
Thank you. Oh, this look like the, how do you say, coral?
Coral, yeah,
yes.
Yeah,
coral.
Exactly. That was my design. I was feeling the Little Mermaid when I
made
this.
I want to touch it too. Oh my god, it feels so... It feels so really comfortable.
It's funny, isn't it?
Yeah, it's funny.
I don't like the things you can do with clay are just amazing.
Oh,
just really exciting.
So it's a necklace.
Yeah.
Oh, so big. Oh my god. Oh, it looks really pretty.
Yeah,
oh.
Thank you.
Oh, wow. Oh, it's amazing.
Yeah, I like things a bit chunky.
Yeah.
But you can buy smaller. I have smaller necklaces. So these are some of the things I've recently finished and need to put on their cards. But there's a couple of like pendants in there that will be on a necklace.
Yeah. Yeah, the necklace that I bought is like this.
Yeah. So that's the, you know, I showed you the metal outside bits in the box. That's the same. And then there's the mushroom.
Oh wow, the mushroom is so cute.
So that's metal, the back is metal. I stuck it onto that.
Yeah.
One of those wooden one.
Yeah, they look like the vintage.
Yeah, that was I felt like it was the right thing to do. Sometimes you get a feeling, you know.
I was a teacher for 10 years. I taught English to students from different countries. I lived in Vietnam for 3.5 years and taught English there. And came back to England and continued to teach at that school. And then the manager left and I got promotion. And it's one of those things where they offer you and you don't want to say no because it feels like a good opportunity, but actually the money wasn't very good. And that's why I quit.
Oh.
Because childcare is so expensive.
Yeah.
I could do my job 40 hours a week. Yeah, it's a lot. And there was a lunch break. So I did teaching for 10 years, then I was a manager for 1.5, well, I was assistant to the manager, and then I was the manager, so overall, maybe 3.5 years in management, and yeah, you don't really get many breaks, and you don't,
it's
a lot, and the money would pay for my child to go to nursery,
yeah.
And I would have maybe £200 left afterwards, and never see my child. So we said, you know, why are we doing this? Why don't I just quit my job, look after my child full time?
Yeah.
And then I thought, you know, I'm going crazy just looking after my child. I love him, but after he goes to bed, I need something for my brain.
Yeah.
So I started doing this.
Right.
Okay, do you want to come and sit down and see me do some
work? Sure.
Okay, so what we're going to do is I start off with different purple metallic, a kind of teal, I think they call it peacock pearl, silver, and this is just translucent clay. So when this bakes, it will become not quite see-through, but it won't have colour. And you'll be seeing a little bit through it. And very thin, it will be see-through. And the reason I'm using this is I'm going to put it between the layers so they don't mix together too much, so that the colours feel a bit separate.
Okay.
So that's my plan. So the first thing we have to do is condition our clay. Clay comes in packets. It lasts for years. It never really goes bad.
Yeah.
The only way to ruin clay is to heat it and cure it.
Yeah.
So important thing to do, another really important tool is blades.
Yeah.
These are sharp, but they're sharp, but they're not super sharp. The pasta machine is here because it's what we use for conditioning the clay.
Mm-hmm.
You can do it by hand, but it takes longer. And the best way to condition clay is to start by warming it up.
Make it softer.
Enough to get through the machine, because you don't want to put hard clay through, it's just going to break.
Yeah.
And then I put the machine down to a low level. And you can see where the metal particles are. It's called mica powder.
Mm-hmm.
The mica particles in the clay move around and face in different directions.
Yeah.
So in order to get them all to face in the same direction, you have to condition it for a little while.
Yeah.
And it doesn't matter for this technique, but there are some techniques where you really want it to work in the same direction. Another important thing while I'm doing this is not to get air bubbles in my clay. So when I fold it, the fold is always down to the side. A lot of people find this type particularly difficult to work with because it does get very, very sticky. And you can see that's because it's unconditioned.
Yeah, it's much drier than the blue one.
For now, although feel it, it's really sticky.
Yeah, it's sticky.
So what I need to do is I need to condition it to mix the polymers and everything together properly. And once it's conditioned, you won't have so much of this happening at the edges. It looks much more smooth. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to
cut it
into a shape so I can stack it together. Mm-hmm. So I'm just going to go for a kind of rectangle shape, especially with metal clays and translucent clays, metallic clays.
Cutting it.
So I'm going to make all the pieces the same size and make a stack. Keep that there actually. And I can stack it on top again.
Why do you choose to use clay?
I saw videos on the internet.
Oh.
And I thought, you know what, they're so amazing. I just thought, what an incredible material.
Mm-hmm.
When I was a child, I had a necklace that was polymer clay and it had turtles, and someone had made it one of these, and I don't know where it is now, which is really sad. And I remember how incredible it was and thinking, like, this is just some of the most amazing material.
Yeah.
Now I'm going to put, so you can see I've got translucent, green translucent.
Yeah.
And I'm going to go, and I'm going to put another colour now on top. Mm. And put the
like biscuits with our cheese.
Oh my god, which is one of my favourite things in the world. I'm going to put, what am I going to put next? I think I'm going to go for pink next.
Okay. This pink is so shiny.
Yeah, so all of these have a metallic
yeah.
element to them, apart from the translucent. Translucent clay won't change the colour, but it will help with the texture a little bit. Can you see where the edges are, not the cutters, but around the edge? Can you see where the clay's breaking apart? Mm-hmm. So with a really good quality cutter, it won't do that on the middle part, and it hasn't, but on the edges it will do that. Yeah.
Hey Charles. Hi. Hi.
So this is the most interesting thing that you've found right now.
100%. It feels so exciting all the time.
Yeah.
If it ever wasn't exciting anymore, then I would stop. But I can't see how, because I'm always learning new things, and it's such an interesting material.
Yeah.
There's so many things you can do with it that I just feel like I'm never going to get bored. And there are artists in the clay, because I didn't rub it all down, this peels off much easier.
Yeah.
There are artists in the clay world who've been doing it their whole lives.
Yeah.
Like a lot of older ladies doing it.
Okay.
Yay!
Oh, thank you for watching.
Fantastic.
Now you want to go and try, right?
Yeah, definitely.
You've got to go and play. Yeah. So much fun.
Please.
Okay, so this is the daily work life that I spent with Sarah. And I am really looking forward to her future works. And if you are also interested in her works, you can follow her Instagram and visit the market that she attended.